Before we start the video, let me give you a brief introduction about myself. I'm Chandresh Mahajan, who is founder and chief educator at Exergic, which is India's most trusted and comprehensive institute for online GATE preparation. I got an All India rank 37 from GATE Mechanical Engineering, and I am an ex-Indian Oil officer, having 6+ years of teaching experience as of now. To know more about our GATE courses, you can contact us on these details. Also, you can download Exergic GATE preparation app from Google Play Store. The link is available in the description of video.
Now, let us have a look at this question, which will teach you, I think, one very important lesson. For any of the topics of mechanical engineering, any of the questions of mechanical engineering. So, this question may look a regular question, but it has very important learning. Question says that a helical spring is fabricated by wrapping wire of 19 mm diameter around a cylinder of this much mm in diameter. This question is talking about fabricating, means making a spring. And how the spring is getting made? We have discussed about all the different ways that how in industries it can be made, the hot working can be done, cold working can be done. But in this case, in this question, it is talking about a specific way to make it by wrapping the wire around a cylinder. That is also something that we know, that if you wrap the wire around a cylinder, it is going to take a shape. The outer shape of it will closely relate with a shape of cylinder if you just wrap it with the paper, right? In this case, you have a cylinder and you are wrapping the wire over that cylinder. Okay, so if you wrap this wire over cylinder, right, and then you remove the cylinder, what shape you will be having? A helix shape, right? That is the shape of the spring. The diameter of the wire of the spring is given to you as 19 mm. So small d is 19 mm, and it is wrapped around a cylinder which is having this much diameter. This diameter here, how much is this? It is 203.2 mm. And many of the students, what they will do, they will put capital D as 203.2 mm, which is incorrect. We know what is capital D from the discussion of springs. We already know the notations. Capital D represents mean coil diameter. It is not the inner coil diameter. It is not DI. 203.2 is actually DI. It is not DO. Or sorry, it is not mean coil diameter. It is not D. And it is obviously not DO. So if question gives you DO or DI, please don't take it directly as D. Many of you will do this mistake in the question, right? Be very specific about that. Question has not given you mean coil diameter. It has only given you inner coil diameter. Because if you wrap a spring around a cylinder, the cylinder is touching the inner part of the spring. So that diameter is the inner coil diameter, right? Further, the question says that the number of turns required to permit an elongation of this much mm, right? Let me circle the important numbers here. So, the number of turns of the spring, obviously, which are required to allow or to permit an elongation of this much mm of the spring, obviously, without exceeding a shear stress of this megapascal, is how much? So it is basically asking you that how many turns you have to give in the cylinder so that the elongation is restricted to 101.6 mm. It permits only this much elongation. Also, the stress criteria is mentioned that shear stress should not cross this much megapascal. Value of G is given to you and it is asking you to ignore curvature effect. We know that shear stress can occur due to three different factors: the direct stress, the torsional stress, and due to curvature effects. The stresses due to curvature effect you have to totally ignore as written here. So only direct stress and the torsional stress, direct shear stress and torsional shear stress you have to consider. Using that, you can find out the value of shear stress. Let us do that. So if you look at this diagram here, this is one coil that I have shown. This is the inner diameter. This is the mean coil diameter. This one, which is shown using dotted line, is the mean coil diameter passing through the center of both of the coils at each end. This is the inner diameter. Inner coil diameter plus half of the diameter plus half of the diameter on either side will give you the mean coil diameter. So in a way, inner coil diameter plus D, D by 2 plus D by 2, in total D, will give you the mean coil diameter. You have both the values, DI value is here, small d value is here, put them, you will get 222.2 mm as the mean coil diameter. Now, we have been given two conditions. One is the condition of elongation, other is the condition of stress, right? We know the expression for both of them. Consider it like any regular question that we solve in strength of materials, where question may give you both the conditions. Like you have a case of torsion, where it has given you the condition of shear stress also, that it should not cross that much. So from the strength criteria also you have to design, and it has also given you that how much angle of twist is permissible. So from the deflection criteria also you have to design. Let us start with the stress criteria. We already know the expression of maximum shear stress that we can apply, right? If it is saying you that it should not exceed this much shear stress, means you can apply the expression of maximum shear stress. We already know that if we ignore the effect of curvatures, this is the effect of maximum shear stress. This value is known to us in megapascal. Rest all values are also known. D is known, small d is known, rest are constant, but only P is unknown. Let us find out the value of P from this expression. And please don't think it's a regular question. We will find out the value of P here. We will put in the other. There is one very important learning from this question that will be applicable for a lot of other questions also. So pay attention. Also, one more small thing here, that since this unit is in megapascal, so I can make the units coherent by keeping them in Newton or mm, since this is Newton per mm square, right? So if I keep all the length dimensions in mm, I will automatically get the value of P in Newton, because this one, tau max, is in Newton per mm square or megapascal. So directly I am putting this value here. Some of you will start converting it unnecessarily. They will convert all the length into meter. They will convert this into standard unit of Newton per mm, or sorry, Newton per meter square, which is a waste of time, waste of your efforts, right? So this, a very small tip, but not for the first time I am telling you. I have told this tip a lot of times. So putting the value of tau max here, 8P. D value is coming from there. This is where I have written it. Pi is here. D cube is 19 cube. 1 plus 19 plus 2 multiplied by 222.2. So in this expression, only P is unknown. Solve them. You will get the value of P as 1442.726 Newton. So this much is the value of P. So we have done the strength design from the strength criteria. Now comes the deflection criteria. And this is the interesting discussion. In the deflection criteria, we already know the expression of deflection of the spring. I have written it down here. Del is equal to 8p d cube n by g d to the power 4. G value is also known to us, right? P value we calculated. Capital D is 222.2. Small d is 19 mm. Delta value is also given to you in the question. Del value is also given to you. Deflection, which allowed value of deflection is 101.6 mm, right? And from this, you can find out the value of N. So you may think that's such a simple question. What I can learn from this? Let me tell you. Just put all the values here and solve it. You will get the value of N as 8.651. Question is asking you number of turns of a spring. Now, number of turns of a spring, at first, you will think that it should be an integer value. It should not be a decimal value, right? Let me tell you, number of turns of a spring can also be in decimal, because it is specifically in this question, it is very much possible. You are wrapping the spring around a cylinder. If you wrapped it a full wrap, you give a full turn, it's a one turn complete, one full turn. But if you only moved it up to half the distance, it is half turn. Right? In this specific question, it is possible. If it was a standard industrial grade spring, the chances are less that number of turns will be an integer. But for this question, it is possible. But even in that case, whenever you are solving such a question, you get an exact number like 2.5, 8.5, 6.5. Somehow you got that number. Only then consider the integer value. Otherwise, always consider that if number of turns are asked, they have to be in integer only, right? It is true for majority of the things in mechanical engineering. Whatever is the subject, I can give a complete list of these things. You have also solved many such questions where number of turns were required, number of some parameter was required, which cannot be a decimal value. It has to be an integer, right? And as a result of that, you have developed a habit, a natural habit. Wherever number of something is asked, point number one, you start considering it always as an integer. You totally reject the idea of decimal. You don't read the question, you don't read and understand the situation carefully, which may not be true always. As I told you in this question, if the answer was coming exact 8.5, it would have been a correct answer in this specific case, right? But as we know that generally for any suitable, any appropriate use, number of turns of a spring are complete, right? That's how they are made industrially. They have a very clear designation of how many turns they have. So these are in reality number of full turns, full complete turns. Now tell me, what answer will you put? Will you put the answer as 8 or will you put the answer as 9? Again, what you will do? Many of you will put the answer as 9. That is what you did. This question is asked in GATE mock, All India GATE mock of Exergic, second All India GATE mock. And close to 85-90% of the students have done it incorrectly. They have picked 9. Why? Because it's a habit. Whenever you have a decimal, you want to convert it into an integer, you always choose the next integer. That's how we have been doing it, right? Whether it was a radiation shield in case of heat transfer or any other case where number of members were required in any of the design subjects, right? But have a look here. If you increase the number of turns from 8.651, if you chose the value of 9, basically this value is more than 8.651. What are you telling? You are telling that the value of n has been increased from 8.651, which means the value of del will also increase. All other factors we are not changing, we are only changing the number of turns. Question, after solving, it clearly told you that if you want the value of del restricted to this value, number of turns should be 8.651. Now focus only on this expression, only on del and n. Forget about rest of the values. All of them are same, not changing. The value of n, if you want to permit or allow only the deflection of 101.6, is this one, right? We put the value of del as 101.6, only then we got this answer, right? What we have a habit, recall the other subjects, any of the subjects, whether it is heat transfer, any other subject from any other topic from fluid, thermal topic, or the design topics, almost in 8 problems out of 10, what do? We convert that into a higher integer. We see this value and we say that no, it has to be converted because the number of turns cannot be in decimal. Let us convert it into 9. We will require at least 9. That funda is incorrect here. You cannot apply that here because if you increase the value of n, in this case, the del value will also increase. Rest other things are constant, which clearly means that del value will cross the value which is allowed of 101.6 mm. So you cannot convert it into the next greater integer. You have to decrease the value from 8.651. If you want to make it an integer, that you can do by keeping the value of n as 8. So this is one of those rare topics where if you have something in fraction, in decimal, and you want to make it an integer, you don't convert it to higher integer, you convert it to lower integer. There are more couple of such concepts in mechanical engineering. Always keep your mind open whenever you are solving a question that whether I have to make it an integer or not. Some of you can miss this concept. And if you have to make an integer, whether it should be higher or it should be lower.